ladies and gentlemen. This is the weekly tarot psychic reading for the horoscope sign of Sagittarius. And what this is much like my Instagram focus and swipe, except for this is a video version of that, where you focus on one of these three cards with in mind a question that you want answered from God and the universe, and or an area of life that you'd like the universe and God to look into for you. And when you focus on that card, I will flip over the card, let you know what the answer is or the advice that the universe would like to give to you. And then after I'm done interpreting each of the cards individually, I will do a reading for the general signs for Sagittarius. And bear in mind that this is a reading that we are doing for the coming week, starting April 29th on the Monday. It's a reading for Monday to Monday, that next week, and I'm uploading these now on the weekend here, starting each Friday to get these uploaded in time for that coming week. All right, now to start, this will be card number one. In the middle, we have card number two, and at the side here, we have card number three. You take the time, as I've been talking here, to focus on which card you'd like to see the answer for, and I will get to flipping them over. So with that being said, if you have focused on card number one, the answer the universe would like you to look into, peaceful resolution. If you have picked this card, card number one, and the universe is telling you that you will have a peaceful resolution, then you may have resonated with that card if you were going through a conflict or some kind of confusion, or even in a state of unawareness about the outcome of something. If you have been feeling like you need something to be resolved, then the universe is letting you know that you will see peaceful resolution about what it is that you are dealing with. If you have, for instance, asked this card about, I've seen this card come up before, if a person is asking about if they're going to get back with an ex-partner or go back to an ex-job position. When I see the card peaceful resolution, that's an indication not of the word romance or the words big happy changes, but that the situation you're dealing with will come to an end. It will come to a completion. And when it comes to a completion, at the very least, it will end in a peaceful sense. It won't be dragged on to forever and ever, amen, in the terms or world of conflict. Now on to card number two. If you have picked card number two, the universe, that's hilarious. The universe would like to show you about romance. This is something that I just thought may pop up. For those of you who come into this asking for whether you are going to find a soulmate or whether you should be with an ex-partner, anything that you have thought about in a romantic sphere, you may have been drawn to getting card number two. And if you have asked a question about a romantic situation and you've gotten card number two, then rest assured you are looking to have romance in your life. That may not be with the person that you are currently with or the person you hope to be with. It may come out of left field and be somebody you have not met yet or something you may not have thought about. Nonetheless, you've got romance coming up, and that's always a wonderful thing to feel in the moment of it. And when it happens, whomever it is that brings romance into your life, treat them with an appreciation for who they are, because you're never going to meet another person like them, and they're going to have a certain set of talents and skills and an outlook on life that is going to be unique to them. And so too will their version of romance be unique to them. Also be careful that everybody's romance is different. Try not to get involved into romance that is toxic, because toxic romance is still quite romantic in the end. On to card number three. If you have picked card number three, your answer is if you believe. Now, if you have resonated with card number three, the universe is asking you to listen to your intuition, and I'm actually giving you some direction on this one. I would say for you to look into your intuition, and I want you to ask yourself, does the question that I ask when I come to this tarot card reading, whether that's will I get a job, will I get money, will I get the romantic partner I want, whatever the case is, whatever that question is that's in your mind, do you answer that internally inside your mind with more yeses, it will happen, or more no's? If you happen to have more doubts go off about this circumstance, or more excuses that you don't have what it takes to get that job or land that location or whatever, if the no's and the doubts are there too much on your topic, you likely won't be able to fulfill what you need or what you're looking for or hoping for when you come to this tarot card reading and ask a specific question. However, if you literally say inside of yourself, when you ask yourself that question, do I believe that I'm going to get this outcome the way that I want? And the answer is, yeah, I think I'm going to get it. Then you are already in the vibration, and God and the universe has already put you in the vibration to get your goals accomplished. So that is up to you. It is up to whether or not you believe that you can obtain the goal, or if you're actually tricking your own self and lying to yourself and you just don't want to believe it. You just don't want to be aware of you lying to yourself. Some people do act like that. And they would then tell themselves, oh yes, I believe. But then those doubts constantly creep in. Things often don't work out when those thoughts of doubt creep in. And that's usually the universe and God facilitating you out of something in your life. But if the universe is facilitating that instant response of, yeah, I think it'll happen, and maybe only one or two doubts flies in your mind and you always keep hopping back to the, oh, well, I think it'll happen because of this, or maybe if I try this, it'll happen. If you've got more of the maybes than you've got the I don't think so's, you're on a good path. But if you're too negative, then this is why the universe is warning you to adjust your thought process. If you believe it, you will bring it into fruition. That includes doubts, and that includes successes. So, to read this in a general reading for Sagittarius is to bring in the future with them for this next coming week of April. You can see, first off, a sentence, straightforward from back to front, it would be written as, there's a peaceful resolution, and once the peaceful resolution is experienced, there will be romance, and the romance will turn out successful if you believe, or unsuccessful if you believe. And so Sagittarius is out there in the future, like I said, regardless, are going to face this period of romance. Whether you are coupled with somebody right now, whether you haven't met somebody yet, whether you put romance on the back burner, Sagittariuses are going to be experiencing that. And just so you know, it may not be the spring season, although this spring season is called the season of the heart and the season of love. And so this spring season is, it's called that because of all of the intense moons that have happened, like within Libra. Libra is the sign of love and relationships, and we just had two full moons in Libra in a very unique layout. And so for Sagittarians, they happen to be a sign that is experiencing the world of romance this year in 2019. This is about the week, though, of April the 29th. So what I see happening here for a lot of Sagittarians is that resolution and the ideas of a peaceful resolution of a conflict that some Sagittarians, or a lot of Sagittarians, have had out there. Conflict that you Sagittarians have had lately will come to a peaceful resolution. You will see that phase start to happen this coming week. Once that phase completes itself, and that part might take a month or two, but once that resolution is concrete and you don't have conflict in that area of your life that you may have conflict in as you've approached this reading, most people do have one area that they're concerned with when they come to a tarot card reading. Well, whatever the conflict is, you will come to a point in time where you realize you can breathe a sigh of relief. And then also, like I said, you guys have, this is a two events here. This is dual event. A lot of other people dealt with a storyline front to back that said things like, keep positive, big happy changes, right? That's like centered in on, hey, you can keep positive because of this event that's coming. But this reading is two separate events that we have going on for Sagittarians. That is the first reading out of the group of horoscope signs that I've had that for. Not surprised, because everyone's journey is different. But as one of the things to keep your eye out in the future, Sagittarians, keep an eye out in the end of April, beginning of May, that you go through resolving some kind of a circumstance. It even could be fighting at work with coworkers, fighting with family, whatever that is, after the conflict that God has you in. Once it is resolved, Sagittarians are being phased into a romance phase. And you will be tested on monitoring your thought process of belief in love, belief in possibilities, and the need to maintain compassion when dealing with romance. So Sagittarians, you guys are very, very shoot your own selves in the foot sometimes because you're so blunt. And if you do have a phase of romance coming up and you're a Sagittarian that resonates with this, and in the future you see that happening, and you can come back to my comment section and be like, yes, I did experience this romance in 2019, shortly after April when this resolution happened. If you happen to be one of those people who you realize, okay, I've just transitioned into that phase of romance, please remember what I'm saying right now. Treat this position of romance without having to shoot yourself in the foot because you're being too forceful or too blunt. Treat this romance in the future with compassion and with firm but compassionate boundaries. Also make sure, like I said, use your wisdom of discernment wisely. Don't let anybody step on your boundaries as well if you do end up being in a romance situation later on in this year. And I will leave you off with that. Thank you very much, you guys, for tuning in. If you'd like a private reading, feel free to direct message me on Instagram at Liny.Dee.Tarot, or contact me in my email, which I will put in the description below once I upload this video. All right, thanks a lot, guys. Bye now.